We present a method for designing and fabricating kinetic characters made of metal wire. We start with a deformable steel wire. The straight wire deforms plastically at large displacements. By introducing spring-like templates along the wire, we can avoid plastic deformation and also tune the stiffness and thus the deformation behavior. But how can we select an appropriate template, given some desired behavior? And what should the parameters be for that template? Our pipeline takes a rig, or a set of curves, as input, and produces an optimized wire structure that closely matches the input motion when actuated with cables. Selecting and optimizing templates is a discrete and highly non-convex problem. To navigate this complex design space, we first identify regions where the stiffness should change. To select which template to use, we plug in generic templates where the stiffness should change. These capture the behavior of our fabricable designs and offer a continuous optimization space. To replace the optimized generic templates with fabricable ones, we retrieve behavior-preserving templates from a pre-built database. After inserting these templates, we refine their parameters. The resulting shape is fabricated with a DIY Pro wire bending machine. To increase the gamut of the database, we also allow for coils. These are added manually in a post-process. And here is the finished result. The finger is able to match the targets well and does not deform plastically. Here we show another finger, overlaid the rest pose and the simulated result for the four target poses. Although the fabrication introduces some error to the rest shape, the result is able to match the four targets well, and it returns to the rest shape with no plastic deformation. In this example, we start with an animation of a walking dinosaur. We specify target points for the neck, tail, and legs. Here is the optimized result. We fix the body in space. This is the whole animation sequence. Here is the physical dinosaur, which is actuated by 10 servos controlling the lengths of the cables. We also add 3D printed shells to the wire. Here, we design the legs of a walking robot. The input is 8 points in the gait cycle. For the points where the leg is touching the ground, we take into account the weight of the robot. Here is the simulated result. And here is the fabricated robot. For this three-fingered alien hand, we optimize each finger for a grasping motion. We place pulleys along each finger so that the cable remains inside the shell of the hand. We actuate the cables with servos inside the palm. We add 3D printed shells, and the resulting hand is safe to interact with due to the compliance of the wire. Here, our input is a character climbing up a wall. Here is the result for the rest pose. The two cables are slack. Here it is in the first pose. The two cables allow us to match the targets better. Here is the second pose. and finally the third pose, where we're climbing over the edge. Here, we optimize two desk lamps at different scales so that the bulb follows a vertical straight line when actuated with a single cable. We account for the self-weight of the wire and also the weight of the bulb. Here, we have an animation of a swimming fish. We extract six contours from the mesh, which we couple at nine locations. We simulate the deformation of the complete wireframe, but restrict templates to lie along the central spine in order to preserve the wireframe appearance. Thank you.